Yeah. Oh, well, I wasn't from Ohio. Better late than never. Anyway, thank you so much. I am so honored to be included with some pretty incredible people. I'm a little shocked when Graham first called me and said, you have received a Medal of Merit. I said, really, why? Why me? And I just said it was an accomplishment in my career, which I guess just goes to show if you work for Donald Trump long enough, you will eventually qualify for a medal. And I called my brother, and he said, is OU now in the business of awarding Purple Hearts? I said, this isn't streaming, right? Monday morning, I'm tired. I'm very close, I love him. And right now somebody is saying, this is not the script she sent in. And right now, I know, two minutes. I used to time the Academy Awards, so just start up the playoff music and I'll be fine. It is true. I have been blessed in my life and so many incredible opportunities, and not the least of which is coming here to OU. And I would like to thank the Alumni Association Board of Directors and President Mrs. McDavis and Dean Shepherd for considering me worthy and deeming me worthy of this award. And without a doubt, I have to thank my husband, Carl, who absolutely has the patience of Job with me and my crazy job and the crazy beauty queens that are always coming in and out of our lives. I think you like that part, though. We actually have a former Miss Teen USA here tonight who is an OU. She's a bobcat, so. She wanted to go into communications. Our VP of Legal said, oh, you've got to go to Northwestern. And I said, if you know what's good for you, you'll go to the best school. So here she is. Truth be told, when I picked up the phone about almost 10 years ago, and it was Donald Trump on the other end offering me the opportunity to prove yourself and run one of his companies, I prayed. Well, I think I got sick first, and then I prayed that I would be able to rise to the occasion. And 9 years later, and several beauty queen pageant scandals later, for a while there, I think I had my own rotating guest chair on Larry King. It was like I got in touch with so many friends through those scandals. I know that I never would have survived had it not been for the skill set that I acquired here at OU and at WOUB. Any success that I have has its roots here in Athens, and I thank the university for that. I'm an outpost daughter, and I was from San Diego. I had never been to Ohio before. I didn't even know what I wanted to do. I knew that I needed to go someplace different, someplace new, hopefully someplace without a Navy base or an ocean. And I succeeded. Boy, did I succeed. Hawking's not quite but I thank the powers that be every single day for whatever divine intervention led me here and led me from California to the center of excellence that is the Scripps College of Communication. And as a member of Dean Shepherd's advisory council, I would like to say to President Davis, to Dean Shepherd, and faculty and staff at the College of Communications, I understand, and even through running my own company, I understand the frustrations that you deal with being creative with your budget, and always having to find new ways to deliver the highest quality education possible. And judging from all of the interns from OU that come through our program, you are succeeding beyond your wildest dreams. And I would like to say on behalf of the students that you're teaching and those that you're yet to teach, thank you. Because I know that that you are affecting their lives and you are making a difference, just like this institution made a difference for me. And I don't know what the shape of the entertainment or the communications business is going to be. It's in a great state of flux and a lot of speculation. But I do know that the young men and the women that you are teaching here today are going to be the ones that will shape its future. And I just want to thank you so much for honoring me tonight. I am really proud to say that I am a product of Ohio University. So thank you very much.